Welcome back inside Lumpini Stadium, the mecca of martial arts. And we are here at One Friday Fights, and we move to flyweight mixed martial arts. Tran Nhoc Luong faces Kaito Oda. Oda is younger, he's taller, and he's got a slight weight advantage as Vietnam meets Japan. Global rules flyweight mixed martial arts. We're going 3 5-minute rounds. The bout is judged as a whole, not round by round. Knees to the head of a grounded opponent are legal. No spiking or throws on the head, neck, and spine.
From the blue corner, Kaito Oda!
Kaito Oda from Japan has some fans inside Lumpini Stadium getting a nice pop as he's making his walk. Ryan, this kid showcased some spectacular grappling in his debut, getting that unanimous decision over the ultra-tough Kupar Royale. Really just outworked him everywhere. He's a strong grappler, but in tonight's matchup, we might see some high-level striking from this young man.
That's right, Mitch. He is an orthodox MMA stylist. He says, you know, I like striking. I'm comfortable with my striking, but I feel like I'm stronger on the ground. However, he has knocked out some opponents on his feet, so he is no slouch on the feet. What I was really impressed with last time, Mitch, was his physical strength and his composure. You know, he spent time in the self-defense forces of Japan. It has really made his mind and his body strong. On top of that, like so many of the Japanese fighters with that never say die attitude, it makes for a very formidable opponent. Tonight, I would like to see him use his footwork and his striking, feel things out, and maybe use it to set up that takedown and use some of that top pressure because he's so physically strong.
I heard a story about him in the Japanese self-defense forces where he spent 3 days and 4 nights in the mountains of Fukuoka, where he had to carry 50 kilo bags. He didn't have any food, he didn't have any water, he didn't sleep. And it was just an incredible story of ultimate toughness. And it just goes to show you just how tough this young man is.
From the red corner, Tran Nhoc Luong!
Undefeated from Vietnam, Tran Nhoc Luong out of the Saigon Sports Club. The Rabbit is making his One Friday Fights debut. This guy's undefeated, Brian, and his nickname, The Rabbit, actually comes from the Energizer Bunny, right? Because he just has this endless energy and constant work rate, but he's also taking on The Rabbit as kind of like an alter ego, right? Where he is small, but he can evade, and he's quick, and he utilizes his speed to fight back and dominate bigger opponents. So that's really what he wants to do here tonight, is showcase all the skills that they has made The Rabbit one of Vietnam's top mixed martial arts prospects.
Mitch, he has that orthodox kickboxing style. He loves him in. He realizes that Brazilian jiu-jitsu is so important to add to his arsenal that he even studied English so he could learn from his instructor. So you know that he is going to bring a very diverse skill set here, not only on the feet, but also on the ground. I think, though, his advantage on the feet is going to be very important for him tonight. I would like to see him work the body and the legs, and then if he feels comfortable, set up that takedown with his overhand.
Very interested to see where this goes. Let's go and hear where these guys are from.
Coming up is 3 5-minute rounds of flyweight MMA. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Carpe Diem Fukuoka, holding an MMA record of 4-1. Representing Japan, Kaito Oda! his opponent out of the red corner, training out of Saigon Sports Club, holding an MMA record of 4-0. Representing Vietnam, the Rabbit, Tran Ngoc Long!
Watch out, no headbutt, don't hear back the head. Watch out, low roll, and keep the fight inside the ring. Okay, touch the glove. Back to corner.
Referee Kemp Chang with the final instructions.
Just time, ready.
One Friday
ready.
Fights.
Go!
Is the pinnacle of martial arts. It's the entry-level platform in search of rising talent who can be future world champions. With the big right hand, sends Tran crashing to the canvas. Tran recovering, trying to tie him up, looking for the butterfly hooks. What a massive right hand. I said on the walk we were gonna see some of that striking, and Odak delivers in the very first minute, sitting down Tran. What resilience coming from the Rabbit now, as he's trying to slow down the onslaught that's coming his way from Odak.
Wow, what a start from Kaito Oda, showing his physical strength, leaping in on that right hand. Now he's in a position that he likes a lot, where he was very effective in his last fight, and that's being on top and grinding and pounding, Mitch.
Oda, very aggressive. This is what we saw from the match. He was just so explosive and strong, especially when he gets opponents down on the back. You can see Oda is trying to pass the guard, but he's running right into now the triangle. Let's see if Tran here can lock up this inverted triangle. He reaches up and pulls down on his left leg to try to create a lock. He might be able to do so, but looks like Ola's gonna try to posture up and get out of this.
Would it perhaps a little overzealous in a very dangerous position here?
Now the inverted triangle is in. It's slowly getting tighter and tighter. Oda's strong. Oda's got a really tough neck. He's good at defense, especially when it comes on the bottom. Tran doesn't quite have the arm in the position he needs to finish. And Oda was able to pop out. But that just goes to show you just how equipped Tran is. He's very dangerous with his submission skills.
We're not kidding, Mitch. That was a very, very dangerous situation there for Kaito Oda. He needs to make sure that when he's on top, that he doesn't get overzealous, that he stays patient and composed. He's not just going wild for the knockout.
Oda heavy in the ground and pound. Now Tran trying to work his way up the corner, and he does. Good job from Tran to work his way back up to his feet after surviving a very dangerous position and getting starched and sat down in the very first. Good bicep control as he fires off the knee. Tran Ngoc Long out of the Saigon Sports Club. Two-punch combination and exits.
Tronic did a great job of recovering, getting back to his feet, and then controlling there in the clinch. Like I said, hand fighting, the knee. Looking patient, composed. He is for sure back in this fight.
Oda really looping around the guard. Heavy punches, brilliant leg kick. Off-balances Oda, but Oda very aware of the positioning, able to turn the corner. He runs right into a guillotine attempt. Doesn't quite look like Tran has the proper position of it. Keeps that front headlock position. Expect Oda to try to pass the guard, try to get that knee in between and get past to work his way into a more dominant position. He's so strong in half court, he should just stay there and just hammer fist and really try to slow down Tran, because Tran is very tricky.
One thing that really impressed me in Oda's last fight was his conditioning, Mitch, and his ability to keep the pressure on, to hold the position in the scrambles, really fight to get back to the top and stay there. And he's doing a great job of that right now. And as this fight wears on, I think we'll see more and more how his conditioning comes into play.
Go hold it.
Giant gas tank for Kaito Oda. Keeps a huge high pace the entire 15 minutes, as we saw in his debut here on One Friday Fights. Now he's sitting into side control. Short little shots with the left hand. Good job by Tran to work his way back into half guard. But Oda is just relentless and trying to pass. The rabbit gets back up to his feet. Showcased by Oda as he takes down Tran Nguyen Long. 10-second clapper is down. It looks like we get another 5 minutes here at flyweight. Kaito Oda, what a first 5 minutes, Brian. It all started with that explosive right hand, I believe it was, that sat down Tran in the very opening segments of that round. Take a look at it again. Oh, it was a left followed with the right. What explosive punch. He covers distance so fast. And then it was just this the entire rest of the fight.
Such a dynamic start from Kaito Oda. Here leaping in on the left, following with the right. Really hurt Tran there early. But elbows here in the clinch too. But Tran demonstrated incredible fortitude and is really back in this fight here. He's gonna have to figure out how to deal with the pressure though from the get-go.
We spoke about the gas tank of Oda, but you gotta be very well conditioned to take a shot like that and work your way back into it. The best athletes in One Friday Fights will eventually earn an invitation to one. Nice little stand switch right there from Oda as he gets right into the pocket. Trying to do damage to Tran as Tran gets that body lock. Oh, beautiful step across. Just driving Tran right into his face.
Oda doing a good job there in the clinch, looking for the sweep, but really, Tran is very effective in this position, fighting for the underhooks, controlling the hands. Some knees here from Oda. Really doing a great job dealing with the physical strength of Oda, who is so strong and has the ability to just ragdoll people, but he is not getting away with that right now.
Go hold it.
Good overhook, short elbow landed by Oda. Now, ladies and gentlemen, keep in mind this is the global rule set. Fights are judged as a whole, not round by round. That's kind of why I said the first 5 minutes and the second five, because it's an entire fight. Think of it like a one big 15-minute round with minute breaks in between the five-minute segments. Short little knees landed to the legs of Tran by Oda. Oda answers back inside that clinch, little shoulder pop from Oda as he frames off to fire another knee to the body.
Both these guys utilizing knees to the body, to the legs. Oda even throwing in the shoulder shuck, a great technique, but now they're squared off with some space between them. See what Tran can do on his feet. I like the calf kick in. Off his back foot there, very clean 1-2, Mitch.
Tran pushes Oda up into the ropes as Tran trying to stay nice and tight on that clinch, but Oda's doing a good job of some dirty boxing inside there, attacking the body, mixing things up well inside this clinch. Frame it off, driving his head into his shoulder with the palm. Shoots in for the double leg and drives Tran back down to the canvas.
Oda once again demonstrating his physical dominance, just so strong. Great timing on that takedown. That's exactly what he needed to do. He's scoring points, and this is where he likes to be.
You can see a familiar face inside the Tran corner. Ty, a former One Friday Fights fighter, is in his corner, screaming at him to get back up to his feet. You gotta have that urgency. This is your chance. This is your debut to really impress the boss. You have to go out there and give it everything you have. You do not want to have any regrets if the match does not go in your favor and you feel like you could have did more. See, this is right where he doesn't want to be. He doesn't want to be holding the head and controlling posture. He's got to put his feet on the hips, try to push off, create some space, and get back up to his feet. He's tricky off his back, but the submission attempts really aren't coming that fast right now.
No, you are absolutely right, Mitch. Open up the guard, push away, create some room, get active. It's not just about protecting yourself, not receiving the damage. You have to create opportunities. I'd like to see Tron work to get back to his feet. He seems to be very effective there.
Wodak's doing such a good job of closing the distance, getting inside the clinch, doing the dirty boxing, and then ultimately breaking his opponents once they hit the ground. Tran's doing a good job with the butterfly hooks. I know it's so easy for us to say, just stand up, but that's really, you know, you gotta have the, you know, the technical prowess to sort of, you know, frame off, create the space, push off the hips when you get a chance. But when you have a monster like Oda on top of you, easier said than done.
1 minute.
That's the thing. And you can tell that Oda is also very well schooled. He picked a perfect time to shoot that takedown. Now he's in this top position, dominant here. He's dealing with a very active guard here from Tran. But he's doing a good job of holding the top, trying to work through.
See, I think Tran hurt us. He pushed off a little bit, but Oda is just so strong and so powerful that he just keeps collapsing the guard and getting here and just doing ground and pound. And he's very active on top here.
He's staying busy, exactly. He's finding openings for those little shots. He's not just laying there and defending. He's trying to advance the position. He gets in the full guard, he works in the half guard. He's trying to move into side control.
Watch it.
And really, his conditioning is showing as well, Mitch.
Tran trying to lock up the head, control the posture of Oda.
Stop.
And wait. The second round comes to a close. The second round ends just like the first. Domination coming from the man from Japan. Very strong grappling game, looking good on his feet, taking this fight where he needs to go. Interesting second round, but it's one-way traffic, and that traffic is headed to Japan.
That is right. Look at this move here. Working to hit the hip toss and then the elbow, a variety of strikes. Oda staying busy on top. There's that elbow again. Definitely getting his opponent's attention, scoring with the judges. Oda is strong and fit, but we are officially now in deep water here in the third, so we will see who is the fittest.
The question for every fight is, how badly do these fighters want it? How badly do they want that pot of gold at the end of a rainbow? You need to dig deep within yourself and pull out an incredible performance every single time these bright lights are on. And that is where Tran is in the third and final round. What can this young man bring to the table? As Oda lands a big left hand, shoots it for the takedown. Good defense so far from Tran, but look for Oda to turn the corner. Yep, try to tap that hit knee and look to drag him back down. Picks him up with a body lock. Another tough, grueling takedown series from Kaito Oda.
Just demonstrating again how well he has been coached when it comes to these scramble positions. Just like in his first fight, he does a great job about coming out on top, both literally and figuratively. He is so good here and so dominant. And it's that physical strength, but it also too is his will and his persistence. He keeps working to improve his position.
I like the chain wrestling he's doing. He's not just shooting for one takedown, and then if he doesn't get it, you know, he kind of resets and goes at it again. He's blending the wrestling together. He'll shoot him for a double, he'll turn the corner, he'll look for a single, he'll grab the body lock, and it's so difficult to deal with because eventually he will get what he wants. He will not be deterred. And Tran is legit on the ground. He's an undefeated fighter with several submissions on the ground. He's very talented, but he's just getting outworked in these crucial positions. And he's gonna go back to his gym back in Vietnam, and he's gonna go, okay, these are the types of things that I need to work on. I need to dig underhooks. I need to push the head down. And he's gonna grow from this matchup here tonight.
Learning a lot on the job. Oda here continuing to be active in the guard of Tran, throwing punches over the top. His conditioning still looking great, very aggressive. You know, proving he's got that mentality, that mindset, that's why wrestling can be so effective. He's chaining the takedowns from one move to the next. He is not, when he needs to push, he really does. Eureka and Tran being active with his guard, but Oda over with the punch, working to get to side control, continually trying to better his position.
I'm impressed with Tran's guard. He's got a very active guard. He's not just trying to hold Oda in position like in the closed guard. He's opening up the guard, trying to attack, trying to put his feet on the hips, and he's trying to sweep, right? He's not just allowing Oda to dominate on top and, you know, cruise out the victory. He's looking at pushing on the hips, trying to get back into full guard so he can mount some kind of offense. Look at Oda setting up an arm triangle now. Can he get to the other side? If he can get his body to the other side, there's a possible arm triangle right here. He's in full mount. Is he in mount? Yes, he is in full mount. Yeah. Now he's just smashing his head. Just a mean move right there. Just bouncing his head off the canvas like a basketball.
Oda just so persistent, so strong here, just grinding his way into mount. He used that anaconda choke, that hand and arm, to get to this position, and now he's on top, and he's just letting the punches fly. Great work from the fighter from Japan here.
Oh, the power! See, sometimes you just gotta stand up. Sometimes you just gotta throw caution to the wind and take big risks, as Tran is able to just throw Oda off. See, that's the chain, right? Right in there, he was going after the double wasn't there. He grabbed the single, turned the corner, and sat down Tran. Beautiful example right there of the chain wrestling where you need to commit and you need to find an answer. And that's the puzzle that Oda just solved right there yet again.
It's heart and tenacity. It's good coaching. It's working with good partners. Just great conditioning here and aggressiveness. Oda once again absolutely smothering his opponent. Tran, who is no joke, like you said, active in the guard.
He's trying, man. He's trying to be tricky, but Oda is just one step ahead. Just like in chess, you're dealing with a grandmaster at this point, and he's just so good at outworking you. He sees what you're doing, he knows where you're trying to get to, and he has an answer for it every step along the way. Oda's gonna be a problem for a lot of fighters in this division. He's just so strong and so relentless. And look at the gas tank.
He was taking risks. He was driving, looking for that victory to the last minute. And that's what we look for. That's what we want to see. Great job. Wow, what a fun fight.
He got caught too. He took a risk and he ate a big up kick. Walked right through it, continued to ground and pound. 15 minutes of just total annihilation from Kaito Oda. Look at this, just monsters. That was the big shot. Look at that, just explosion. Every time he commits to shots, whether they're on the ground, on the feet. Kaito Oda, impressive performance from the man from Japan. Let's send this for the official announcement. We pretty much all know where this is going, but what an impressive fight. But I'm also impressed with Tran. Nguyen Long really stayed in there, tried to do his best, had some big moments, but just wasn't enough. And I think both these fighters are gonna grow and learn from this experience. Let's go to Nara for the official announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. Kaito Oda!
Kaito Oda extends his record to 5-1. The Japanese prospect continues his role on One Friday Fights. Another impressive victory here against an ultra tough opponent. This is where the match started. Look at that beautiful left hook, the straight right combination. I thought he was gonna get him out of there, but the toughness of Tran Nguyen Luong really showed, but the night belongs to Kaito Oda. Ladies and gentlemen, what a start for the Japanese fighters, but we move to the 116-pound Muay Thai division. Nguyen Van Tan takes on Haruyuki Tanizu.